Sunday. This lesson name is Statistics. So last class I have explained how to draw a frequency distribution table. Are you remembering that? So now we will do the sums from your textbook. See the first question. Here you can see they have given black groups of 30 students of class 8 are recorded as follows. They have given the black groups of how many students? 30 students. And they have given the black groups like this. And now you should represent this data in tabular form or frequency distribution table. So how to do that? So which are the black groups they given? Black groups are that you know, which are they? A, B, O, A, B. Okay, so which are the black groups? They are black groups are black groups are A, B, O, A, B. See, see here, black groups are A, B, O, A, B. In this one, so the tabular form, first column you should write all the black groups. Second column, number of students. Now how to write the number of students? How many students are getting or having black group A? See this data. How many students are having black groups A? That you should write here. So see here, black group A. Count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many students are having black group A? 9 students. So what should write? Black group A. How many of them are having black group A? 9. Which is the next black group? B. How many of them are having black group B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many of them are having black group B? 6. Next. Black group O. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total how many? 12 students. Let me see how many of them are having black group A, B. See here, black group A, B. 1. Here see, 2. 3. So how many of them are having black group A, B? 3. Now we will count these all. Total how much you will get? 9 plus 6. 15. 15 plus 12, 27. 27 plus 3, 30. So total how many students? 30 students. In this given question also they have given how many students? 30 students. So our answer is correct here. Okay. Now, now, the second question, here they have given 3 coins worth of 30 times 17. the number of heads you are getting, they are given like this. So what do you want to draw? You should prepare a frequency distribution table. So given one data, in this one they are showing the number of heads occurring. So you should draw one frequency distribution table showing this data. So how to do that? See which are the numbers they given here. 0, right here, 1, 2 and 3. 4 numbers they given, which are they? 0, 1, 2, 3. See the first number 0, how many times it is occurring? See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many times is coming? 6 times. Now we see the number 1. How many times you are getting 1? See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, only 10 times. Next you see, how many times you will get the number 2? See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many times it is? 9 times. Next you see the number 3. How many times it is occurring? See, this row 3 is not coming. Next row you see, 1, 2, 3. Next, 4, 5. Total how many times? 5 times. When you take in the total of this, what you will get? 16, 16 plus 9, 25, 25 plus 20, 25 plus 5, 30. So, they have given, it is tossing 30 times. So, total also you are getting 30. You will see the another data and you should make a frequency distribution table which are having class size 5. With the class size 5, you should make frequency distribution table and the class interval first will be starting from 150 to 155. Why we are taking the first class interval? frequency, you should write here. The base is now. Draw a tabular form. First column, you should write all the class intervals. Second column, you should write the frequency. Now we see the first number we will take 150. So which one? It will ends at 155. Next you should start from 155 to 160. Next 160 to 165. Last one 165 to 170. So you should make frequency distribution table having class size 5, starting from the class interval 150 to 155. Now we see the first class interval, which is that 150 to 155. What is 150 to 155 means? In this interval, 150 is including, but 155 is not including. What is this interval means? In this one, 150 is including, 155 is not including. And you should write all the numbers which are having less than 155, which are having frequency less than 155. See the numbers which are having less than 155. Start from 150. See the first number 150 here. And less than 155. See, 152 is less than 155, isn't it? So second one. Next you see 154, that is less than 155. Count this one. Now only this much. You will take 155. No, what is the reason? Because in this interval you will not include 155. So total how many is the 1, 2, 3? Total how many? The frequency is 3. So when you are giving part data, first of all, by the given question, you should write the class intervals and then write the corresponding frequencies. First class interval is 150 to 155. That means 150 is including, 155 is not including. And count that data having less than 155. See, count here. 1, 2, 3. Only 3 is there. So the frequency is
3.
See the second class interval, which is then 155 to 160. So 155 is including, 160 is not including. So start from 155. So 155. See term. Can you include 157? Yes. What is the reason? Because 157 is less than 160. So this 157 you should include. Now what about 158? That is also less than 160. And next, which one? But again 158, that is less than 160. So include that. 155 is including, so this one you should count. Total how many is there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Total how many? 4 is there. So, can you understand this? How to do count this? Then we see the third class interval, which is that 160 to 165. In this interval, 160 is including, and count the numbers which are less than 165. See, start from 160. What about 161? That is less than 165. So include this one. Next, 162, that is also less than 165. Include this one. Next, 164, that is also less than 165. This one you can't include. mistake, no? 169 you can't ignore because 169 is greater than 165. 170, no, you can't ignore because in this interval you will not get 170. 162, that you can take. What is the reason? Because 162 is between 160 and 165. Ignore this. Can you ignore 155? No, because that is not in this interval. Now you count the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then how many is there? 5 is there. Last interval, which is then 165 to 170. 165 to 170 means 165 is including in this interval, but 170 is not including. So start from here. 161 you can't take. What is the reason? That is not between these two numbers. 150 you can't take. 152 no. 162 no, you can't take. 164 also you can't take. 157 you can't take. Next 158 no. 163 you can't take. 165, what about 165? See, 165 is including, so count this. 154 no. 158 no. 169, see, 169 is between these two numbers, so count this. Next, last one, you see, 170, you can't count that. What is the reason? Because that is the upper limit. Next, 162, you can't take. 155, that also you can't take. Total, how many is there? In this one, you will get only 1, 2. Total, how many is there? 2 is there. Now, you count all the frequencies. This total frequency, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 5, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, total 14 numbers is there. See children, similar type of sums I will give us homework, do that and send through WhatsApp. Thank you so much.